Before Alex attempts to take on the Dutch Masters, he first needs to do something about the nasty crack down the entire length of one of the tabletops.
It's the moment of truth now, really. It's time to put a clamp on this, and this will be the moment where I find out how difficult this job is going to be. If it closes up nice and easy, it's just a matter of popping some glue in there, and that will set, and then I can just patch these small bits of veneer. There's no movement at all there. That hasn't quite gone to plan, and it hasn't moved at all. It's completely solid, which means we're going to have to go to plan B, flip this over, and put a cut right the way across it at the bottom, hopefully taking all the tension out and closing it back up.
Alex is hoping once he's cut the underside that he'll be able to gently prise the table apart. It's a nerve-wracking process and extremely risky. It's crucial his blade depth is accurate, as cutting through the other side to the veneer would severely damage the marquetry.
I've got a feeling if I pull this now that the whole thing will split into two, which, although it looks a bit drastic, is actually what I need. Well, there you go. Half a 18th century Dutch marquetry tabletop. I'm just going to use a very soft brush to take out all the dust that's built up in the gap so that when it's all glued together, it gets as tight a joint as is possible. Now's the moment of truth. Now I'm going to cover it in glue, I'm going to put the clamps on, and it has to go back together. It seems to be closing up fairly nicely. I'm going to pop a few more clamps on just to keep it stable whilst the glue sets. And I can look at patching those little bits of veneers, but in terms of losing that crack, that has gone as well as I could have hoped for.
In Alex's workshop, the pair of 18th century Dutch marquetry tables are undergoing a serious cosmetic facelift. Having taken drastic action with one of the tables by splitting it in two, Alex now has to make good on the damage.
What I've got here are lots of different timbers. So we've got bur walnut, we've got some maple, we've got pine. So all these different timbers have all different colours, all different characteristics, which we match to the original panel so that we can lose this crack. So as with any veneer repair, you always do your veneer patch a little bit bigger and then just trim it and trim it till it's the right size. That's my first patch cut. That's gone in nice and tight. The next stage is to do this little piece next to it. This leaf makes up the rest of the size, so I can use that as my template just to score down here now. It should fit in nice and snug. I've completed that small section now. It's only five pieces of veneer, but they're cut nicely. It completes a little area. I'm going to glue these in now and tape these in, because the last thing I want are these blowing away and having to cut them again. Lovely.
Working his way down the entire length of the split, Alex will need to repeat this process, replacing all the damaged pieces.
They're very time consuming to do, so once they're done, get them stuck down and move on to the next stage.
After years of neglect and sun damage, Alex is keen to see how the tables will polish up.
As you rub it with the wire wool and the mess, it takes the very top surface off the timber, and that just reveals all the natural colours that are hidden underneath. I love this part of the job, when I get to just clean up a piece of furniture like this. We're not taking too much off, but the beauty of the piece has been hidden over the years. This is when you start to see why a piece of furniture like this is worth so much money.
In Alex's workshop, the marquetry tables are receiving their finishing touches with the help of some repurposed wood.
This is ebony timber and boxwood. Now, ebony, obviously, you can't buy anymore. It's an endangered species of timber. But what I tend to use are old piano keys. We break them up, we repurpose the timber. Those pieces are fitted really nicely. I just need to do a little bit of boxwood to go in between.
and then we can glue them on. And once that glue's set, sand it smooth and wax it again.
6 weeks ago, when dealer Tony Gearing dropped off the Dutch marquetry tables, they were in dire need of some cosmetic surgery. Alex has had them both under the knife, and they're finally ready to be handed back.
Tony's on his way. I'm excited and nervous to see what he thinks of them. Tony really brought me a challenge this time. I think the majority of dealers would have walked past this and thought, too much work, not worth the challenge, not worth the risk.
I'm very, very nervous, I must say. This is an undertaking for any craftsman.
Tony. I don't know what to look at first.
How are you?
How are you?
So which one's yours?
Very kind, this one.
It's outstanding, Alex, what can I say? You've made a work of art.
Thank you very much.
To the centre of it.
I've taken sort of the same elements on this one, but blended them together.
Turning his 21st century skills to the tables, Alex has sympathetically restored the original marquetry of the badly split tabletop. Handcrafted an entire new panel in pear, boxwood, satinwood, and walnut. These tables now look worthy of their Dutch cabinet-making heritage once again.
I mean, I love that the colours match perfectly from the serpentine stretchers to the top. It's a masterpiece by a master craftsman.
I do feel like we've saved it.
You have, and that's what the whole antique game is about. Yeah. They're just a pair of unique tables. Mm. That's what you've, there's the selling point for me. They're just eye candy, aren't they? I'm almost a little bit lost for words, and that's quite unusual for me.
Blimey, yeah. It's unusual for you, isn't it?
It's faultless. It's absolutely faultless. It's a lovely, subtle restoration that's been done so sympathetically, an absolute exquisite job. It's the best restoration I think I've ever seen.
In a state of near ruin, Tony paid a lofty £4,000 for the pair. But Alex's restoration has taken them into a completely different price bracket.
8 to 10. Absolutely, definitely. I'm going to start at 10,000. I've always come down.
Tony likes the tables. Massive relief. I mean, given the amount of time I put into them and how these could have gone very badly wrong, he can see a profit. He's a dealer, that's the main thing. And he's trusted me to put a bit of, you know, play my part in history, these gorgeous tables.